If you're looking for supplies, I'll make this easy for you. There aren't any. But something tells me you're not here for that. What do you want? I take it my men were dead. It's a high price to pay, but these supplies will save a few lives here. Thanks for finding these. You should check in with the Major. He'll want to know about this.
Hello. I'm glad to see you here. We could definitely use your help. I heard. The extra supplies will help for a short time, but that only solves one of our problems. With all the Legion raids lately, we're running low on troops that can still fight. Some are injured, but even more are dead. I want you to check in with Dr. Richards and see if he needs any help getting our troops back on the front line. Thanks again for looking into my missing medical supplies. Now I can actually use them on people that need them. With business booming like it is, and considering I'm the only person with medical experience in the camp, I could perhaps use a hand. Do you have any medical experience? Excellent. As you can see, we have a lot of injured troopers here, and I haven't had time to look at all of them yet. Since you have some medical experience, I'd like you to examine them and see what you can do to treat them. Ah, look who it is. What brings someone of your renown into my humble medical center? Excellent job. Where'd you learn to do all that? I don't think I could have done much better myself. Very impressive. As for the men, they'll recover soon and be back on the front lines in no time. Huh, the circle of life. I'll send word to Major Politely about your work here. Once again, you have my sincerest thanks.
Hello.
kind of busy around here for social calls, so if you're not here to help out, just stay out of my way. Dr. Richards said you did a good job in there. That's mighty high praise coming from him. With the help you've given us, we're doing a little bit better, but we still have the Legion forces at Nelson to deal with. If we can retake Nelson, that would be a huge help to our efforts in this area and give us an advantage at Hoover Dam. Reports have the Legion forces at Nelson sizable, but not insurmountable. Not really, but we don't have much choice. If you help out more around camp, I could spare some additional men for the battle. Come back when you're ready.
Hey.
I bet no one has ever been as unnoticed as me. Okay, I'll go away.
You've heard of the Sierra Madre Casino. We all have. The legend, the curses, foolishness about it lying in the middle of the City of the Dead, buried beneath a blood-red cloud. A bright, shining monument luring treasure hunters to their doom. The world's most famous stars and entertainers were invited to its grand opening. An invitation was a sign of exclusiveness. The opening was supposed to symbolize a road to a brighter future, not just for the world, but for all who came to its doors. A chance for anyone to begin again. Except, the Sierra Madre never opened. The war froze it in time, like a big flashbulb going off. The grand opening. One big ending of humanity. It's still out there, in the wastes, preserved, just waiting for someone to crack it open. But getting to it, that's not the hard part. It's letting go.
Are you listening? Good. From now on, when I talk, listen and follow my instructions. Play stupid. Play clever. Make the mistake of saying no. That collar on your neck will go off and take your head with it. It's like that pit boy on your wrist, except filled with explosives. A little radio of the old world. Just needed some tune. Do what I say, and the collar will go off. Refuse, try and run, disobey me, I'll kill you and find someone else. There's no escape from here until I let you go. The sooner you accept your situation, the better. That structure you see above the fountain, the Sierra Madre Casino, you need to break inside. Heist. Too many years in the making. But to get inside, avoid its traps, you'll need to gather a team. As I found, one cannot do it alone. Around the villa were three other collars like yours. Collar 8, 12, and 14. Find all three and get them here to the fountain. Then we'll talk more. And should you get any ideas about killing each other and taking the treasure of the Sierra Madre for yourself, a warning. All your collars are linked. One of you dies, you all die. If that's what it takes to make you cooperate, so be it. Because in some respects, breaking into the Sierra Madre is easier than breaking human instinct. Greed. The villa is filled with corpses. Some killed by the dangers here, some by me. Others turned on each other. Once they realized the Sierra Madre could be theirs, they cared nothing for their freedom, their survival, or each other. The ones brought here live on only in what they've left behind. Their marks, graffiti on the walls, and victims they've killed. Some tried to help, left supplies and healing for others who came. Their reward? They were tracked down, killed by others with baser instincts. Some of these murderers went as far as to leave traps behind them, turning markers for help into death traps for anyone following them.
It killed some of them when they forgot where the traps were. Or when they desperately needed the assistance they had cut others off from. Too many, many. This place is dangerous. And its quarantine measures, its hazards, have claimed many failures upon failures. You think I wanted to place collars on you to ensure compliance? No. If robots could have done this, I would have sent them. The Sierra Madre is a complicated lock. Cracking it open requires human hands. The Sierra Madre has many defenses, means of screening guests for illicit or dangerous items. Your arrival here, weaponless, was not my intention. The casino, this villa, it takes anything with even a trace of radioactivity, traces of unknown substances, and returns it home, the bunker. The process is automated, and the casino itself has other similar services. I was unable to find a workaround except to send others in as tools. Still, I have not left you defenseless. And the Sierra Madre's security, in some respects, can help you if you are resourceful enough. This place is well preserved. Few who came here ever returned. All of the treasures of the old world lie scattered about, virtually untouched. Search, hunt, craft what you can from what you find. The trash of the pre-war era can keep you alive. Food, knives, more. Use them. Even the villa's toxins and the residue it leaves behind can be shaped into tools and weapons. Gather it as well. Also, there is one more thing in your possession. A rifle that will keep you alive. As surely as the collar will. It is a hollow rifle, a weapon I constructed when I arrived. I have since made superior models and modifications. For now, that tool will have to do until you find other weapons. And I suggest you do. The hollow rifle's ammo is limited. Still, it should serve well enough. I fashioned it from the holograms of the villa and used it against the villa's living inhabitants. Yes. The inhabitants. Avoid them if you can. They are difficult to kill. Whatever has created them, bullets, explosions, energy, it can make them inert for a time. Then they seem to crawl back up, restored. Perhaps it's the clock. Perhaps something in their physiology. The cloud is what blankets the sky here. You may smell it in the air, copper and sulfur. Burns the lungs and seeps into the skin. As for its origins, I'm not certain. Pre-war industrial pollutants, something in the Sierra Madre structure. It is unique across the wasteland and deadly. It has kept this place preserved since the Great War. The air here is lethal only if you enter concentrated pockets of the cloud. Too long inside one, you'll die, so be careful when you step. I've seen some survive concentration of the cloud for short periods of time, if healthy enough. Others were too weak. Rebreathers, chemical suits, there is no protection against it. It decays all it touches. I found fighting it useless. Anywhere sheltered from the cloud, inside buildings, tunnels. Any place not exposed to the outside air. Anything the cloud has touched has preserved it one way or another. But only the holograms in the villa truly remain. Ghosts. They fill the villa. More in the casino. Much more. They carry out the functions the dead once did. They cannot be harmed. They only perform the same rote tasks until their power dies. They are of no consequence, except for the security holograms, the ones with the silhouettes of the armed Sierra Madre guards.
Most holograms perform specific functions. These security holograms, ever since the bombs fell, now perform their function. They will kill anyone they detect. They are immune to guns, weapons, EMPs, even energy weapons. Still, they have limitations. Their design limits their field of view, enough to avoid detection. Each has an emitter, destroy or disable it, and they cease to be a threat. Still, at least they still work as intended. Other technology here is more of a threat to you. Notably, the villa's radios and speakers. Yes, music was intended to be broadcast all over the villa. Over time, however, the radio signal has decayed and emits a different frequency. Speakers and radios interfere with the bomb caller frequency and can trigger the detonators prematurely. It is an unfortunate side effect, one I did not anticipate. I was unable to calibrate the callers to block the signals. So, you'll have to make do. Yes, but not immediately. You'll hear a beep from your caller's detonator. When you do, step back, scan the area, and find the signal source. There are damaged speakers and shielded ones. The damaged ones you can destroy at range. Don't get close. You can't switch them off like a radio. The damaged speakers are sparky, hard to miss. The casings are resistant to vandalism. Punching or hitting them will not destroy them. Gunshots, energy blasts, even spears thrown with great force can puncture their exterior. Shielded speakers can't be destroyed at all. You will need to avoid them or switch them off via a terminal. I'll leave the method up to you. I am short on patience, and you are short on time. I brought you here. There are mechanisms in place once the traps across the Mojave are sprung. For now, your sole focus should be the Sierra Madre and how to get inside. Until then, you won't leave alive. I've downloaded the instructions and markers on your Pip-Boy in case you forget. And yes, I have access to that device on your wrist. Get the other three here after that. I'll have more instructions for you. Do this, I'll let you go. I'll let all of you go. Your piece of Rocco trash will help you, I've ensured it. It can latch onto the signal of the callers and tune into their frequencies. The bomb callers come with radios embedded in them. You can eavesdrop easily. It was part of their design to listen in. They can even screen out white noise from the environment to allow greater monitoring. One is a trusted ally, obedient, caller unknown, although the caller helps. The other two, well, we'll have to see what the trap's got. Yes, caller eight. The FEV reject, the super mutant. He is docile, predictable, and provided he's not starving, should be easy to command. I lost contact with him some time ago. Probably after he dragged you here from the trap. Find him. He'll follow you, caller or no. A long story. FEV, a virus is an even longer story. It gave birth to the docile one. Turned them into a super mutant long ago. Good. If necessary, I will guide you through the villa's broadcast systems. If you get lost, return here and I'll direct you. I've downloaded instructions on an audio log to your Pip-Boy in case you can't read. If you forget why you're here, let my voice remind you.
Are you listening? From now on, when I talk to you, pay attention. I've left markers on your Pip-Boy. Find the three other callers in town. 8, 12, and 14. Get them to the fountain. Obey me, and you can all go free.
That's the way out after you break into the Sierra Madre's vault. Try to leave. I'll set off your collar. Watch out for the villa inhabitants. They're difficult to kill unless you chop them apart. If you can, blow them up or disintegrate them. bomb caller frequency and can trigger the detonators prematurely. It is an unfortunate side effect, one I did not anticipate. I was unable to calibrate the callers to block the signals. So, you'll have to make do.
Noise makes my stomach hurt. Turn the noise off. Dog in the cage, hiding downstairs. Watching, waiting for you to try and let me go. Get away while you can, before he comes back.